Australia's Great Barrier Reef, 133,000 square miles, nearly 400 different types of coral, and it's all dead. Wait, no it's not. Yeah, it is. Well, maybe a little. Depending on who's posting to your Facebook feed, the Great Barrier Reef is either doing just fine or it's teetering on the brink of destruction. So, should you cancel those tickets to Australia? Is there even anything left to see? A coral reef is an underwater structure made of, you guessed it, corals. And while those corals might look like a collection of snazzy-looking rocks, they're actually the exoskeletons of living invertebrates. They eat, reproduce, grow, all the stuff anything else living in the water does. They also drop dead if the conditions they're living in aren't quite right. Now, conveniently, corals have a pretty clear way of showing their health. If everything's A-OK, the corals will all be colored earth tones, like 1970s living room furniture. When they get sick, they can become fluorescent. And when the coral turns white or becomes bleached, well, then that means it's dying and that its recovery is in question. So, is the Great Barrier Reef dead or not? Well, it suffered a massive bleaching event in each of the past 2 years as a result of rising ocean temperatures due to global warming. The extreme nature of 2016's bleaching led to this, a slightly satirical obituary for the reef that wound up going viral. That caused environmental reporters to try and stop the spread of any misinformation, clarifying that, while the reef was in poor health, it wasn't actually dead. So then it's fine, right? I mean, you might have also seen this in your Facebook feed, a report that UNESCO, the United Nations body that lists the Great Barrier Reef as a World Heritage Site, did not put the reef on its list of World Heritage Sites in danger. Well, that decision was actually criticized on social media, pointing out that the reef is absolutely in great danger, something that UNESCO itself has even previously suggested. So, who's right? Scientists? UNESCO? Outside Magazine? Well, the bleaching events are not normal. Before 2016, there were only 2 bleaching events in the previous 17 years. And while a reef can recover from bleaching, that can take up to a decade, making the back-to-back events that much more concerning. Fortunately, Australia is trying to do its part, allocating over $1 billion over the next 5 years to help repair the reef as part of its Reef 2050 plan. And that's no surprise given the tourism it attracts and its estimated financial value. So, no, the Great Barrier Reef is not dead, but 2/3 of it is damaged with its recovery in question. Now, if someone just shared this video instead of those articles, we can maybe all get on the same page. Please share this video. Hey, the ocean's full of cool stuff like coral reefs. Find out about its mysterious twilight zone in our new series, Science in the Extremes. Don't forget to subscribe and keep coming back to Seeker for more videos.